Now we may discuss types of relations and functions in the chapter relations and functions. Types of relations and functions. Of this, first we may discuss types of relations. You know what is a relation? A relation is a subset of the cross product of two sets. If A and B are any two sets, then a relation denoted by capital R is a subset of A cross B, and we say R is a relation from A into B. It is a subset of A cross B. And therefore, this R will take the form R equal to collection of the form AB with the A element of A, B element of B. So R will be such a collection. A element of A and B element of B. And in this situation, we may say that if AB element of this R, then A related to B. Or it is again denoted by the symbol ARB, which means A related to B, that is AB becomes in this collection. It is a usual notation, representation. So this is the definition of this R. Also, if R is a relation from a set into itself, then clearly R will be a subset of A cross A. This R will be a subset of A cross A. We say R is a relation from A into itself, or simply we say R is a relation in A. So this is the definition of a relation that we know, you have seen it in the last year. And now we discuss some special relations. These special relations are relations from A set into itself. The two sets are the same. That is a subset of R, subset of A cross A. And now there are mainly six special type of relations we discuss. The first one is empty relation. Second is universal relation. Third is reflexive relation. Fourth is symmetric relation. Fifth is transitive relation. And the last one is equivalence relation. And now come to these six relations one by one. The first relation is empty relation. A relation R is said to be a relation from a set into itself, or a relation in a set. A is said to be an empty relation if there is no element in R. That is R equal to phi. That is, no element in the set A is related to any element in the set. R is empty. For example, consider the set A, which is equal to the even natural numbers 2, 4, 6, 8, etc. Even natural numbers. And now we define a relation R such that A related to B if A minus B is odd. A minus B is odd. So consider the set A. This set consists of even natural numbers. That is, every numbers are even. The difference of any two elements is also even. Or difference of any two even numbers is again even. That means there is no two elements A and B such that whose difference is odd. Therefore, no element is related to any element in this A. That is, R consists of no elements. R is empty. So this relation is empty relation. That's all. Now, the second one, universal relation. A relation in a set A, a relation R in a set A is said to be the universal relation if R equal to A cross A. R consists of the full set A cross A, full set. That means every element of A is related to all elements of A. Every element of A is related to all elements of this A. Example, consider the same set A. We define A related to B if A minus B is real. Or A plus B is real. Okay. These are all natural numbers, means these are all real numbers also. The difference is clearly real. Take any two elements. The difference will be real, of course. So, every element related to all elements of this A, that means R is full across A, and hence this is the universal relation. Universal relation. And now consider the third one. The third one is reflexive relation. A relation in a set A is said to be reflexive if every element in A is related to itself. Or a relation in the set A, if A related to A for every A element of A. Every A element of A. The relation is said to be reflexive relation. Every element is related to itself. For example, consider this set A consisting of all lines in a plane. All possible lines in a plane. All possible lines in a plane. There are infinitely many planes. Infinitely many lines. And A is such a set. So elements of A are lines. Lines in a plane. And now we define a relation. A related to B if A and B are parallel. A and B are parallel. Then this is a reflexive relation because every element is related to itself. Every line is related to itself because every line is parallel to itself. A line is parallel to itself. So this line is parallel to itself. This line is parallel to itself. This line is parallel to itself. This is parallel to itself. So every line parallel to itself, and therefore every element related to itself, A related to A for all A in capital A. So this is reflexive. Now, next one, symmetric relation. A relation in a set is said to be symmetric if A related to B implies B related to A. That is, if we are related to A, then B should be related to A also. If we are related to B, then B should be related to A in the reverse order. Then the relation is said to be a symmetry relation. Example. Consider the same set A consisting of all lines in a plane. Relation the parallelism, same parallelism. Then consider two lines A and B. If A related to B, then A parallel to B. Then we see that B parallel to A also. Then B related to A. In the reverse order. A related to B, B related to A. If A related to B, then B related to A. Or A related to B implies B related to A. So this relation is symmetric. This is true for every such a parallel lines. Pair of parallel lines. So that is the definition of this symmetric relation. And now third is transitive relation. A relation in a set is said to be transitive if A related to B and B related to C implies A related to C. A related to B, B related to C implies A related to C. That is, if A related to B and B related to C, then A should be related to C also. If A related to B, B related to C, then A should be related to C also. Such a relation is transitive relation. Example, same set. Consider A, B, C. A related to B, A parallel to B. B related to C, B parallel to C. Then clearly A parallel to C. So parallelism is transitive. With A and C are parallel. So transitive A related to, if A related to B and B related to C, then only we need A related to C. Suppose this line is say D, A not related to D, so we need not consider this. So if A related to B and B related to C, then A related to C also. So this is transitive relation. So parallelism is reflexive, symmetric and transitive also. And now the last one is equivalence relation. A relation in a set is said to be an equivalence relation if it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive. If the relation is all of these three types, reflexive, symmetric and transitive, these three types, then it is said to be an equivalence relation. Example, same set and relation parallelism. It is reflexive, it is symmetric, it is transitive, and hence it is an equivalence relation. That is, parallelism in the set of all lines in a plane is an equivalence relation, reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Okay.